accelerating. We have to get ahead of this curve. We believe you should create a sense of urgency and a culture within the city committed to outcomes. Without a plan, without a schedule, without deadlines, we tend to get bogged down in process and we forget the purpose of what we're doing is to create results and outcomes. So when we talk about investment, what'll it take? One example is Paso Robles. Last year, Paso Robles completed a downtown specific plan, not exactly what we're saying. There'll be some specific plans associated with this, but just to give you an idea of their investment. That was a community of 32,000 people. They spent $1.5 million planning just the west side of their town. That's $47 per resident. If we spent that in Salinas, that would be $7 million in planning over 2 years. We're not suggesting that at this point. But we do recommend we start out at about $500,000 a year. I think this is a modest amount. This amount assumes you're going to be working with the community groups as Jack has outlined in a collaborative approach. And what we're talking about is not growth for growth's sake. We're not talking about paving over the valley, but this was smart growth and healthy growth. You know, Measure V expires in a few years, and we can't wait to start. We can't hope the voters will extend its life. We need it to act now to grow a diverse job base. We believe this is going to grow not only a job base, but higher paying jobs, higher family incomes. It'll grow retail choices and sales. We want to grow recreational and cultural assets. It'll grow our charitable giving and the strength of our nonprofit organizations. It'll grow feelings of security, safety, and well-being. It'll grow levels of city services, and it'll grow prosperity across this entire community. Okay, now this new normal requires not only planning, but it requires, we believe, a new city structure. To start that, we need an organization and a culture that is set up to succeed through efficient use of our resources. And at this point, Lino Belli is going to come up to discuss our recommendations in this area.
Got a lot of stuff up here. All right, my name is Lino Belli. Good afternoon. We'll move to our next slide. And we'll go one more. To respond to the new normal, we must rebuild city structure and organization to serve the community. We need efficient long-term planning to provide for our prosperity and short-term actions to move us systematically forward towards that prosperity. The city appears to be simply reacting to the outside demands. We see no recognition of or plan to address the new normal. We cannot continue doing what we have been doing since the 80s. As a community, we are not getting what we want. The city must engage the community for planning and to assist in delivering these services. And the city must efficiently deliver services. We see that the essential services being broken down into these four areas. We have community development. This is the area that is community development. It needs to be the steward of our economic, environmental, and societal advancement. This is the streets, roads, utilities, buildings, and open space of our community. Think of this as the hardware for our community. It must be planned, encouraged, and maintained. The next area is community services. And community services is like the concierge of our community. This is recreation, library services, enrichment programs. These are, and you can think of this as a software for our community. So these areas must stay current, relevant, and diverse. The last two are public sector services, the fire department, there we go, and the police department. Fire prevention, suppression, and emergency medical, and the police is crime prevention, suppression, investigation. Those are the four central areas. This is the current city structure, and what we have here is we have this first column is the police department, we have fire department, economic development, engineering and transportation, community development, environmental and maintenance, library, and then Parks and Community Services. These are our service departments. Above them are committees, commissions, and boards. And then over to the far right, Human Resources, Finance, City Attorney. These are the support services in our city. We have found that there to be excessive management in this structure, with eight departments providing four core services. This means we have excess costs. Our core functions are misaligned, which lead to lack of accountability. And there's no mechanism for cooperation between departments, so we get no synergistic advantage of having eight different departments. We currently have about 14 commissions, boards, and committees, and they again serve over four core function or service areas. And at this point, before I proceed, I'd like to reiterate what Mark said earlier about that our committee does not take these recommendations we're about to make lightly, that the different positions and departments that you see up on the screen right now, these are hardworking people, people that we work with on a daily basis, and we take this very serious. And so the following recommendations are, in our opinion, the only way forward and are required to address the critical issues facing our community. The first consolidation that we're talking about is to consolidate into community development four existing departments. The first being economic development, the next being engineering and transportation, community development, and environmental and maintenance. So those four departments, include economic development, Salinas Valley Enterprise Zone Management, transportation, engineering, capital improvement projects, airport, building safety, code enforcement, planning, redevelopment, housing, and public works. Again, this is the hardware of our community. It's the built environment. The next consolidation that we're recommending is into community services. Combine library and parks and community service. So this new department would house library services, recreation, social activities, literary programs, and enrichment. This is the software. This is the people of our city. So, and then along with consolidating these department functions, we also recommend reducing numbers of management positions below the director level and maintain the majority of direct service delivery positions. So this is the structure that we need to carry us forward. You can see from this that we have direct alignment between the city council and commissions and the different departments. Let me point out that we have, what I'm showing here now is Public Safety Commission over Police and Fire, a Community Development Commission over Community Development, and a Community Services Commission over Community Services. Presently, we have those 14 commissions, boards, and committees. We're not saying that you can consolidate out in just to three. You'll need more than that. But at a minimum, if you can consolidate these three areas so they line up with the service delivery, it'll make for a much more efficient structure. It'll be easier for accountability between the council, the commissions, and the service providers. And with this map, this drawing also, we're showing support services. Here, finance and human resources, we're showing that they are directly adjacent to the different departments, so they can more directly support the service delivery of those departments, again, reacting to what the community is looking for. We also recommend new effective governance policies to be adopted and followed to foster more efficient government. Simple ideas like requiring new agenda items to be vetted against strategic goals, objectives, and be fiscally sound. In order to engage the community and access the many resources available, this new structure needs to recognize and institutionalize a strong and transparent connection to the departments whose services they can improve and help deliver. This is a recognition of the value of our community resources, nonprofits, sports leagues, faith groups, volunteer, technical expertise, and grants. And that's the last column over here, community resources. So this is a recognition of how important community resources are going to be in the new normal, that we need to show them on the chart and show their proper place. And this is the last piece of a recommendation is for structural and organizational changes. This is not a new concept. It is something your staff is kind of doing now, unofficially without direction. The idea is when a strategic objective is so large that an individual department does not have the tools to be successful, a mechanism is utilized that marshals resources across all departments and focuses them to achieve a desired goal. And that's kind of a mouthful. Let me repeat that. The idea is when a strategic objective is so large and that an individual department does not have the tools to be successful, a mechanism is utilized that marshals resources across all departments and focuses them to achieve a desired goal. So what this slide is illustrating is a city council initiative and a line across all departments, including the community resources group, and with a little circle there showing or representing the involvement from that department and how that department can support the initiative. Think of the power of having a hand-picked crew with the resources of the entire city at their command. They can move mountains. So we are recommending three initiatives be pursued. And now Cesar Lara will illustrate how these structures and organizations can engage the community and focus staff to address these initiatives.
Thank you very much, Cesar Lara. And that's quite a mouthful. You know, there's a lot of information there, and there's a lot of change that we're talking about. And as we talked about the hardware, I think the initiative process that we want to include in the city, I think, is vitally important, and look at that as the software that we're looking at doing. And the new normal that was talked about earlier is trying to do more with less. As city governments, not just the city of Salinas, but across the nation, are facing these issues. We're facing the new normal, and the structure that we're proposing tonight is vitally important, and it really captures what the new normal needs to be for the city of Salinas. And what's really important is that the role the community has in all this, and the role that the city council has in all this. As we talk about city council initiatives, it starts in the community, and it goes down to the leadership that is on the city council, because at the end, the city residents put the trust of everybody on the city council to do the work that needs to be done. And as we face challenges, and we've been facing challenges over and over again, we've been hacking away at the old structure. Now, with the opportunity that the blue ribbon is presenting to you, is look at the new normal. And the new normal would include three initiatives. It's up to the city council. They could add more, they could add less. But the first initiative that we're looking at is youth crime and gang violence. It's the big elephant in the room. As we face the issues in this community, we cannot police our way out of this problem. Once again, we cannot police our way out of this problem. And as we went to the residents last year with Measure K, it showed that the model that we're looking at needs to be changed. It needs to be all inclusive. It cannot just be the police. Because as we know that there is three things, there's prevention, intervention, and suppression to solve the youth violence problem. And we need to muster the resources of the city to do this. Not just the city council, not just the city manager, not just police, but the whole city structure. So as we look at vertical silos that were there before, we need to look at horizontal approaches to problems, to use all the resources that we have in city government to solve this problem. Because at the end, when we talk about police, their main duty is suppression. I think the activities that happened last week were an example of that, is that when they're given the tools, and the tools that we're talking about came from all over the nation, they were in place to do suppression. But to solve this problem, we got to look at the whole structure. Everybody in city